Hey guys, welcome to my legal classes. This is Ganesh Pujari and today let us try understand the duties of Bailee. When it comes to duties of Bailee, I have tried bring a comprehensive video with sufficient case laws, illustration, pictures and all kind of examples available here. Once you go through the video, you will understand the duties of Bailee very clearly. Now who is Bailee? Bailee is the one who is having the possession of the goods. The owner is bailer and he has left the possession with Bailee. Now the entire story of duties of Bailee I am going to construct with the help of a horse. A is the owner of the horse. He want to go for world tour. While leaving for such tour, he is leaving his horse with B. What is the duration of this world tour? He want to go for 2 years world tour. Now the horse is with B. B is the Bailee. Let us try understand with this case scenario that what are the duties of Bailee. First thing first, he need to take care of this horse, which is said reasonable care, which is discussed under section number 151 and 152. Now what happens with reasonable care? He has to give sufficient food to the horse. He has to like give bath and whatever required for a healthy horse. He has to ensure all those requirements. Now let us try understand this concept with the help of two more case laws, that is Union of India versus Udoram and Sons. What happened in this case? The Supreme Court held that the railway company did not take due care. Firstly, they did not prove from record that the railway protection police which escorted the train was sufficient in strength, and secondly that unlike a prudent man, the railway protection police did not keep an eye on the wagons. Guys, they ignored, and particularly when the train stopped, they should have given more focus, but they ignored in that particular time to prevent the theft of the goods. The defendant were held liable, so the railway police had to pay the compensation. That was in the case of Union of India versus Sudoram and Sons. In the case of Dwaraknath versus SN Rivers Railway Company, again a shipment was happening and the train got fire, and due to negligence and the defendants were held liable in that case also. So these are the two case laws you can mention. Guys, if you want to score more and more, you need to bring the section number as well as case laws. That's very important. Let's try understand this second point. Now the first one is reasonable care with section number 151 and 152. Now no unauthorized use. Now this horse of A is being given to B, the Bailee, with the intention that he needs to take care of the horse. He cannot take it to the horse ride and compete with somebody else. He cannot do that because his A's intention was just to take care of the horse during his absence. So B has to do that only. If he is using or misusing without the consent of A, such action is not okay. So it is the duty of Bailee not to do any unauthorized use as per section number 154. I hope that's very clear. With that, let's move to the third point, which is not to mix. Section number 155 to 157 says not to mix. I don't think a horse can be mixed with any other horse and cannot be identified. Such status will not come. But imagine if some kind of rice is available and you are mixing such rice with your rice or some wheat or barley or whatsoever, some agriculture product, if you are mixing with same kind of another product, you cannot separate it. It becomes very difficult to identify whose ownership, or that's very difficult. So it's very clearly said from section number 155 to 157 not to mix with the Bailee's goods. We need to keep separately. So there are four important sections which are saying, the first one being section 155, which says with consent, if the Bailee is mixing up the goods with the consent of the bailer, then proportionate interest should be shared between them. If he is doing without the consent of bailer, as per section number 156, he need to pay the damage as well as pay the expense of separation. As per section number 157, if goods are inseparable, he need to compensate to the bailer. When I say he, the Bailee need to compensate the bailer. And if it is act of God, in such case, cost of separation should be paid by Bailee. There is no compensation as such, but he has to bear the cost of separation. That's about not to mix. So Bailee cannot mix bailer's goods with his goods. That's very important. Now the fourth one, duty to return, section number 159 to 161 and section number 165 to 167. Now it's very important, after the bailer is coming back or after the service is completed, Bailee has to return back the goods to the bailer. That's very, very, very important. Bailer is transferring his possession of goods to somebody else, to the Bailee, for some purpose. Now if you are giving your cloth for ironing with the ironing guy, the purpose is very clear. You want it to be ironed. After the ironing, the iron wala jo bhi hai, he has to give back the cloth to you. That's very important. Same here. So this is discussed under section number 159 to 161 as well as section number 165 to 167. Now if there are joint owners, Bailee can deliver to any one of them. If he is failing to return, then he has to pay compensation as per section number 161. There is an interesting case of JK Mills versus Union of India. What happened in this case? JK Mills wanted to shift some food oil to from Kanpur to Kolkata. When it reached Kolkata, the food inspector there got a doubt that the food oil got adulteration. So he checked and it was got adulteration. So he meets the High Court and High Court says to burn it. So he burns it. But JK Mills put a case against the railway department and it was held that the railway administration to serve the compensation for not delivering the goods. That's very interesting case, JK Mills versus Union of India. Shaw and Company versus Shamson and Sons. What happened in this case? In this case, bailer told the Bailee to ship the goods, but Bailee didn't ship, and the same night fire caught and all the goods were burnt. So in this case, Bailee was held responsible because bailer already told the Bailee to ship the goods and Bailee neglected, and in that case Bailee was held responsible to pay the compensation. I hope that's very clear. Duty to return. Okay, now the fifth one, duty to deliver increase. What happens if there is any increase? Now he has left one horse, but after 1 year the horse got a fall or pony, a small horse jo fall or pony bolte hain. So when bailer comes back, he has to give the horse as well as the fall or pony. That's very important. Duty to deliver increase as per section number 163 to be one of the important duty of the Bailee. Now the sixth one, no deviation from the terms of contract. Guys, A has given his horse to B. The bailer has given the horse to Bailee saying that please take care of the horse. Now what is Bailee doing? He made a cart and he is using this horse for such cart. That is not allowed because he is deviating from the terms of contract, which is not okay. It is the duty of the Bailee to perform as per the contract. That's very important under the special contracts of bailment. Now the last one, not to set up an adverse title. Bailee cannot say I am the owner of this horse, or he cannot say somebody else is the owner of the horse unless he can prove that they have the better title than the bailer. That's very important. Basically he cannot set up any adverse title. That's the seventh, which is discussed under section number 117 of Evidence Act. This is not directly discussed under the Contract Act, but it is one of the section under Evidence Act, which is section number 117. I hope all these seven are very clear. For the purpose of your notes, you can take screenshot of this slide. The first one, reasonable care, section number 151 to 152. Second one, no unauthorized use, section number 154. Not to mix with his own goods. Bailee cannot mix bailer's goods with his own goods, which is discussed under section number 155 to 157. Duty to return, which is discussed under section number 159 to 161 as well as section number 165 to 167. Duty to deliver increase, if there is any increase, that also need to be delivered to the bailer, which is discussed under section number 163. No deviation from the terms of contract, and then not to set up an adverse title, which is discussed under section number 117 of Evidence Act. Guys, thank you so much for watching me. If you have not yet subscribed me, please subscribe. Please share my videos with your friends, classmates, whosoever is interested in this kind of videos. Like and comment my videos. Your comment gives a lot of appreciation, which gives a lot of motivation. So keep doing comments. All the very best for your exams, and see you next time. Till then, take care and thank you so much again.